Angular version 17 was released. And it's not just a huge release because they got a new website and new brand, but because they also added many exciting new features with that version. Of course, as always, whilst being fully backward compatible so that your existing code still works and you can still write the code as you learned it. But we'll take a look at what's new in this video. Below the video, you'll also find a link to a complete blog post with all the details and to my best-selling Angular course, which, I can already say that, I will update. It'll take some time, I can't tell yet when it'll be done, but I will update the course, and existing students, as always, will get the update for free. But what's new with Angular 17? Well, Angular 17 pretty much continues a momentum that's sometimes titled the Angular Renaissance. Because roughly a year ago, when standalone components were introduced, Angular basically started a journey towards becoming a more modern, leaner, developer-friendly, you could say, framework. And Angular 17 is another major milestone on that journey. And that all starts during the setup of a new project already. There, you're now asked whether you want to enable server-side rendering, and you can simply choose yes there, and you'll get an Angular project that's prepared to be server-side rendered. No extra setup, no extra configuration, no adding Angular universal required. Instead, it just works, as you can see if you visit the website, because there you'll then get that pre-rendered content instead of an empty HTML page. And that, of course, is great for search engine optimization. And what's even better is that all that server-side rendering stuff happens in a very efficient and thoughtful way, making sure that your Angular apps are served as quickly and performantly as possible. But that's not all that changes when you create an Angular project. Instead, you'll also notice that now by default, Angular projects come with standalone components being enabled as a default. So therefore, you'll see that the app component you got in a new project is a standalone component. And if you generate new components in the project, those will also be standalone components. Though, of course, you can also easily change that and override that if you want to stick to modules. And this is now probably a good time to also mention and emphasize that whilst Angular gives us all these exciting features and all these new features, it's worth noting that the majority of Angular projects, especially established, big, mature projects, will not use all these features yet. So at the moment, it's definitely also a good idea to learn the old Angular and not just the shiny new stuff, even though the shiny new stuff will of course be important in the future of Angular. Now, speaking of that future, it definitely also includes signals, a feature introduced with Angular 16. In short, signals give you a different way of managing state, so data that changes over time in your Angular applications. And now with Angular 17, signals are stable, though there also are more signal-related features to come in future Angular versions. And what's this if thing here we see on the screen? Well, that's also a brand new Angular feature, a brand new template control flow syntax. You no longer have to use the ng-if, ng-for, and ng-switch directives, even though you still can, of course, but instead, there's now a new built-in syntax which you can use in your Angular templates without importing anything or without any extra configuration. And this new syntax therefore also gives you an easier, leaner, and as it turns out also a bit more performant way of handling conditional or list content in your templates. And that's not the only template syntax Angular 17 adds. Instead, it also adds deferrable views, another special syntax you can use in your Angular templates to defer the load of certain parts of that template to, for example, only load this component and all the related code that's linked to that component if it's visible in the viewport, for example. And that viewport visibility is just one of many built-in supported triggers which you can use with this new deferrable views feature. Now, of course, Angular had lazy loading before that feature as well, but it was more clunky, and especially if you wanted to lazily load parts of a template, that was a lot of setup work to do, and with this new syntax, it's instead now super easy. Now, in addition, Angular 17 also adds many smaller improvements. For example, now you can easily point to a single style sheet on a component because you got a new style URL property in the component decorator instead of style URLs, which always required an array, even if you just needed one style sheet, so that's great. The development server and build process also should be way faster, since Angular is moving away from Webpack, though it's still supported, but it's moving away, and by default, you now got a Vite and ES build setup working under the hood. And there are many other things as well. Definitely check out the links below the video to learn all about the details. Now, as mentioned before, I also got this best-selling course, which I will now update to teach you that latest version of Angular, whilst still also teaching you the old Angular, which you will need in many projects. And therefore, if you're not part of the course yet, you can join with a great discount, link below the video, because existing students will get this update for free once it's done.